Good morning, guys. What's going on? Welcome back. Today is a monumental day in the game, guys, because we are about to hit level 71. And just like you guys, I'm very curious to see what's going to happen at level 71. What heroes I'm going to upgrade. What's going to happen to the Blitz save squads. That's what I'm really, really hyped about because I want to get 5 more teams in there and see what I can work with. So I'm crazy excited to bring you guys this video. We are literally a couple of objectives away from getting to there. So let's not waste any time. Let's get to 71 and let's see what level 71 actually has to bring to us. So let's go. Boom. There's one. There's two. And this one should do it. Skiddly-doo. Whoop-de-woo. Booyakasha. There we go, guys. Level 71 hit. I'm so excited. Another 100. Stamina, we got 250k gold. That's nothing at all, really. What the hell are we gonna do with that? And then 25 cores. Are you kidding me, dude? That's like 25 cents. That's nothing. All right, let's go ahead. We got some energy to claim here anyway. So we're back to a bunch of energy. Let's go ahead, guys. Let's take a look at what's gonna happen now. We are literally at level 71. Let's go right into the blitz here and let's see what's happened to the team. All right, so let's scroll down my teams here and booyakasha, there it is, guys. We've officially added 5 more save slots to the roster. Now I'm very happy about that because right now there really isn't 5 extra squads that you can build, even though I could build an arena team and I could build a raid team and things like that. So it does give me a little bit of options for now, but I wish they did this for every level up to 75. That would have been sick. You get 5 extra spots per level up to 75. That would have been terrific. And then they can keep going with that every single, or maybe do 5 teams per 5 levels. So 5 teams to level 75 and then 5 more teams to level 80. I'm not sure how many heroes will drop by that time. It'll probably be a lot more heroes. But anyways, guys, I gotta work on some other teams now. We gotta build some more teams. But in the meantime here, check it out. The brand new hero into the game, Invisible Woman, Fantastic Four. We're gonna do one battle in the Blitz right now with them. I wanna see how they do in Blitz. And if you missed yesterday's stream, guys, it was phenomenal. We had a lot of fun. But I did not have a lot of luck. It was terrible. I barely got her to 3 red stars. And we opened about 40 red star orbs. It was unbelievably bad. I was tilted out of my mind. I literally could not go to sleep for like 2 hours afterwards. But anyways, let's get on with this battle here. Let's see what the Fantastic Four are all about. And I'm gonna bring you guys a war video on them as well, because I got them at 250 basically right now. So they should be punching up like crazy. They should barely punch up anything even at 400. So right now there's nothing they can get in their way. But let's go ahead now. Let's focus down some different opponents here. We got defense up on Crossbones. We got defense up on everybody. Well, and Vision here as well. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to focus down Vision. I only want to focus down Vision first because of his ability block, which he's going to do right there. Bam it. Damn it. He did it on Invisible Woman there. So we're not going to be able to see her ultimates. But we're going to go ahead now. Get an AoE attack here. And this ability is phenomenal in war because it's going to clear all those buffs here. It's always going to be a crit. So in war, it's so much better than it is in regular arena. That's why Namor is a superior hero in war. But PvE, other contact, is not that terrific. So it is what it is. Now let's go ahead here. Boom. Let's get a nice attack by Mr. Fantastic. Now we're going to be taunted. We're going to go with basic on the thing here. Always get an assist because of Mr. Fantastic, which is phenomenal. That's what I love about this team here. Human Torch there does some good damage. Now we can go ahead and take a look at Sue Storm here. Her ability, ultimate ability here, offense down to turn all enemies with barrier. This is incredible here. Watch this. Boom. Offense down on your opponent. And then everybody's got a ton of barrier now, which is terrific. Now we're going to go ahead with special for Namor. That's going to destroy him here. And here, let's go ahead, finish off nice and slow with Human Torches. Ultimate here. And then it leaves the Fantastic Four signal on the floor. I love that. I think it's incredible. What a great way to end a battle. So there it is, guys. These guys are phenomenal in Blitz. Let's go ahead. this is only 7 tier, but even at 8.3, I'm going to get to 8.3 real soon here. But even at 8.3, this is phenomenal. I love this team right now. Okay, guys, so let's take a look at Invisible Woman real quick right now. Because if you didn't watch the stream, which I know a lot of people can't really watch the stream because they're so long. This is what I did with her. I went ahead and I T4'd her special, her ultimate, and Hard Light, her passive ability, just because she's going to get 10% more max health to everybody, which is good. She needs all the health because of her barrier, and she's going to be able to attack whenever your opponents hit a Fantastic Four ally with barrier. She's going to go ahead and kind of hit them back for some damage, so it's pretty good right there. So I'm loving Invisible Woman now. I'm loving Fantastic Four. I can't wait for the next war to unleash them upon somebody. So that is fantastic. All right, now, other than reaching level 71, the only thing that we got there was 5 new save squads. What are we going to do now, guys? The hard part now is deciding which heroes I'm going to take to level 71 first. Is it going to be a full team, or is it going to be single heroes that I do? And here are my recommendations for you guys out there. If you are also struggling who to go to 71 first, break it down this way, guys. Do single heroes that you use most of the game modes, all right? So personally for me, Captain Marvel, I use her everywhere. I use her in my arena team. I use her in my raid team. She's incredible in raids. I mean, I maxed her out here, as you can see, everything. And I use her in war, obviously, defense. I use her everywhere in Blitz. So she will be my absolute number one hero I'm taking to level 71. Let's see how much it's going to cost. It'll cost you 381,000 gold to reach level 71. I only got about 820 right now, so I can get roughly 3 heroes with the dailies. I'll be able to get 3 heroes to level 71 right away. So I'm not gonna go ahead and do it right now because I'm gonna save up a little bit more, but let's go down my recommendations personally for me, and then maybe you guys can learn a thing or two. So looking down at my team here, Captain Marvel, I use her everywhere. I'm gonna do her first. Another hero that I'm gonna do next is gonna be Falcon. My Falcon is 7 red stars. I absolutely love this guy. He's incredible in the arena offense. He's incredible for war. So those two aspects, I use him, and Blitz, obviously. You can use every hero on Blitz though. So for those two game modes, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna get him to level 71 right away, because like I said, I use him a lot. Other heroes that are phenomenal: Phoenix, I'm gonna get to 71 right away. I use her in my arena team. Psylocke as well. These are the heroes I use in my arena teams. Another hero that I want to get up there is Vision. Vision is in my power armor team for war. So I'm going to go ahead and get him to 71 because I think that I can use him anywhere else as well in the arena. So right away, these are the heroes that I'm going to be working on. And then slowly but surely, they're all going to go up there one by one, guys. Now, getting the gold is going to be really tough. So there's going to be a bunch of heroes that are definitely going to be left behind, guys. But that will be determined by my necessity more than availability, meaning that if I need somebody, they're going to go to level 71, even though other heroes are available to go there, but I just don't need them. So Minerva is another great character that obviously I use her all over the damn place. So she's going to go to 71 really quickly here. So those are priorities for me right now. And then everybody else, guys, I'm going to go work on slowly but surely here. It's going to depend on my team's positioning, how much power I got. So personally for me, Power Armor is my number one team. They're the highest collecting power, so I'm going to work on them first. And then I'm going to go down the list. Defenders, I'm probably going to leave for later on. There's other heroes I want to do first. I mean, the X-Men is going to be second probably. Nick Fury and the S.H.I.E.L.D. team is probably going to be next because of Coulson coming out. Fantastic Four is going to be up there. So all of these heroes are going to have to be worked on little by little. So I'm really excited, guys. But before we end this video, we have to end it with at least one hero getting to level 71. And I'm going to go ahead and do Captain Marvel. Boom! Let's take a look at the increase in power. Alright, so it went up actually quite a bit. 1,400 extra power here just by going up one level. That's phenomenal. And also another thing that I might add, guys, is you gotta check at their equipment. Now this can make a little bit of a difference, believe it or not, depending on how your arena is looking and depending on, you know, who you're facing. But some heroes have equipment that you can put on them at level 71. Some heroes are level 72 and then 73 and 74 and so on and so forth. So for example, Deadpool here. Now, Deadpool is only level 70. You can actually equip two, because they're purple items, you can equip two items to him right away without even getting to level 71, which gives him a little bit of a boost. And then at level 72, he's going to get this blue item, which I don't understand why that's a requirement at level 72, even though it's a blue item. That's fine because we still have these other items that we can put on him right now. So taking a look at my Falcon here, as we can see, one of his items here is required at level 71, which gives him a little bit of a bonus. So if I wanted to, I could go ahead and put him to level 71. This is going to be level 74. And then actually give him an item, which is going to give me a little bit of a boost compared to your opponents, depending on what level they are. If they're level 70, if they haven't gotten Falcon to level 71 yet, you get a little extra boost in their item there. Puts them up a little bit more, and it could be a little bit difference in arena. You never know, guys. Just a little hint out there. You could base your leveling by the level that your heroes need their gear on. Anyways, that's going to end it off for today, guys. Just a quick little sneak peek at what happens at level 71. You unlock 5 extra spots, and you can start equipping some of your heroes depending on if you take them to level 71 or not, and how much it's going to cost you in gold. It's going to cost quite a bit, guys, so start saving your gold as much as you can if you already haven't already done that. So I'm going to end it off here, guys. I will catch you guys on the next video. Till then, have a good morning, good afternoon, and have a good night, guys.